Laura Kampf is one of the main reasons I started my YouTube channel. So to thank her for all her inspiration, I decided to make her a bomber jacket. This is a big project, so I won't go into all the details. However, I do have some more detailed videos about specific techniques that I used, so you can check those out if you want to know more. I'm using a pattern that I made based on a zippered hoodie I have. I cover this process in a separate video. I'll start by making the outer layer of the jacket. I pinned all the pattern pieces to a double layer of fabric and cut them out. The front and back of this fabric are very difficult to keep apart, so I marked the wrong sides with chalk. I also marked the front of the sleeves, since the curve is different on the front and the back. The fabric I'm using frays a lot, so I sewed a zigzag stitch all the way around the pieces to protect the edges. To assemble the pockets, I sewed along the sides and the top. I cut notches along the curve and turned them right sides out. Then I stitched them onto the front pieces. I also added the small waistband pieces to the front. I attached the shoulder seams of the front and back together with a flat felt seam. If you want to learn the details, check out my separate video on that. Next, I pinned the sleeves in place and again used a flat felt seam to attach them. This hides all the raw edges and gives a nice sturdy look. Finally, I used a French seam to close the sleeves and sides. Now I'm ready to add the Laura Kampf patch. On the other side, I added a small pocket. For this pocket, I cut a rectangle, folded the top edge inside twice and stitched it down. I then folded the other edges inside twice as well and pinned the pocket onto the jacket. I sewed along the sides and bottom to attach it. For the flap, I cut two pieces. I stitched them together and turned them right sides out. I cut the top seam down to about half a centimeter and zigzagged around the edge to seal it. Then I sewed it in place on the jacket and the outer shell is done. The lining is basically an exact copy of the outer layer. The only difference is that I'm using the outer fabric around the edge and a thinner black fabric for the rest. I first assembled the individual front and back pieces. And the trick to sewing opposing curves like this is to use a lot of pins and to keep checking your fabric for folds. It took me a few attempts, but I got it right in the end. I cut notches along the curves to allow the pieces to lie flat. Then I pressed the seams down and added a second line of stitching to make sure it all stayed flat. With that done, I can sew the lining pieces together in the same way as for the outer shell. So I first attach the shoulder seams, then the sleeves, and finally I close the sleeves and the sides. On the inside, I decided to add a big pocket for a notebook and a smaller pocket for pens. The big pocket is a welt pocket that sits in between the lining and the outer shell. This isn't very difficult to make, but it does take quite a few steps and a good attention to detail. So for those who are interested, I've made a separate video that shows you how to do this. For the pen pocket, I used the same approach as for the small outer pocket, simply cutting a rectangle and folding in the ends. I then added two lines of stitching to make three individual pen pockets. I finished the lining by adding my label to it. Now on to the ribbing. For the cuffs, I cut two rectangles that fit snugly around my wrists. I sewed the short ends closed. For the collar, I cut a rectangle that's a bit shorter than the neck edge. For the waistband, I also cut a rectangle that's a bit shorter than the waist edge. Now I'm ready to combine all the pieces together. And just a heads up, I've never actually made lining before and basically improvised a way to attach it. There's probably better and easier ways out there, but I got good results in the end. I started by placing the outer shell right side up. I placed a zipper along the front edge, right side down. Then the lining gets added on top, also right side down. Do the same for the other front edge. I sewed along these edges, making sure to keep an even distance from the zipper. Then I cut down the top of the zipper and used a lighter to keep the edges from fraying. For the neck edge, sandwich the collar in between the outer shell and the lining. I sewed along the neck edge to attach it. Now it's really starting to look like something. For the sleeves, I marked the quarter points of the opening and the ribbing. And here's where I really started improvising. I sewed the ribbing to the outer sleeve first, stretching it as I sewed to match up the quarter points. I then folded the raw edge of the lining inside and pinned it to the sleeve. I stitched a second line close to the first seam, attaching the lining and keeping the seam flat. I did pretty much the same for the waist edge, first attaching the waistband to the outer layer and then adding a second stitch line to attach the lining. For the second line, I used colored thread on the spool and black thread on the bobbin. That way the stitching matches the fabric on both sides. Finally, I added the line of stitching along the zipper and along all of the ribbing seams. This keeps everything nice and flat, even after you wash it. I again used colored thread on the spool and black on the bobbin. And that's it! It's done! This is hands down the most complicated thing I've ever made, and I'm really, really happy with how it turned out. I actually practiced all the new techniques first by making a jacket for myself. Laura's jacket is the new and improved version, and of course the motivation that got me to start and finish this challenge in the first place. So I just gave Laura her jacket, and I was so nervous that it wasn't going to fit, but it fit her perfectly and she loves it, so I'm so happy. Laura, thank you so much for all the inspiration you've given me. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.